Sustainability is a key value for the Port of Seattle because we believe that we have to leave this place better than we found it, that we have to create a better world for our children and our grandchildren.
Climate change is one of the most important environmental issues of our time. It's important that we implement any action that we know how to do and implement that now.
The Pier 66 Shore Power Project was a complex technical challenge involving a lot of different parties.
In the end, we got it done because everybody believed in this larger vision of sustainability.
To achieve green goals, even if they seem impossible, we just need to open our thinking. Instead of thinking about why we can't, it's important to think about how we could.
Seattle was a port before it was a city. And as our port developed into a big industrial port with ocean-going vessels, all of that industrial activity had real health impacts. So now at the Port of Seattle, we are focused on reducing and eliminating the industrial impacts on the communities that live around the port. And a big part of that is to ensure that when those ships are at berth, that they plug in.
The Port of Seattle has a vision for zero emissions by 2050, and we've been developing roadmaps and strategies and actions for how to get there.
Everything has environmental impacts, and it's really important that we're mindful of those and work to reduce them in every way we can, and shore power is a great example of that.
Traditionally, when a cruise ship comes into port and is at berth, they need to continue to run their engines in order to power the onboard equipment. And that means the engine exhaust is continuing to emit near our port communities, and that includes greenhouse gas emissions and air pollutants and even noise.
Here at the Port of Seattle, we have three cruise berths that we use regularly through the summer months. Two at Terminal 91 and one at Pier 66. We've had the ability to plug in cruise ships at Terminal 91 for decades, but at Pier 66, we haven't had that capability since the terminal was built.
We started talking about shore power at 66 back in 2006.
It was very difficult to get electricity to because of its location in the downtown grid.
We were looking at the possibility of having to dig through the middle of the downtown core under roadways. That really was proving very, very difficult and very expensive to be able to get that done.
When it turned out we couldn't run a land cable, we had an engineer at the Port of Seattle who came up with the idea of running a submarine cable that would run under the waterfront to be able to provide power to the berth where we needed it.
Bringing the power to the pier via an underwater cable is something that had never been done. And when you do something for the first time, it takes a lot of innovation and creativity to figure out how to get it done right.
Cable's about a mile long. The plan was to have the cable leave Terminal 46, where the power source is, and go out into the bay on the seafloor. And it goes out to a depth of about 230 feet before it makes the turn and comes back towards Pier 66. One of the reasons we go so far out into the cable is if you think of Elliott Bay here as a giant bowl, if you were to string a necklace across the bowl, you'd have this sort of arc shape. It's a lot shorter to go directly, but we wanted to make sure that the cable is as stable as possible and it goes down to depth and then comes across and comes back up.
That took a lot of environmental permitting. We had to work with all our regulatory agencies. We coordinated closely with our tribal partners to get the authority and approvals to run that submarine cable.
We are one of the only ports in the world that has an active tribal fishery happening here that's protected by treaties. So that's something that we had to work closely with our local tribal governments to make sure that their fisheries were not impacted by our construction project. We needed to work with all those constraints with a minimum of impact to get it done in time to plug in cruise ships during the 2024 cruise season.
When we first started the Pier 66 Shore Power Project, a big part of the work was just bringing together a coalition, the cruise lines, the utilities, the city, us, all getting together with community partners to figure out how to make this work.
Because of our beautiful, clean hydropower, we are able to supply electricity that is carbon neutral. What that means is that anyone who wants to partner with us on a project to electrify anything that runs off a fossil fuel, they will be helping to reduce emissions and move to a 100% clean energy future.
We were able to work with Seattle City Light to design and plan a duct bank for the electrical service across our terminal, out to the end of Terminal 46, and into submarine cable across the bay over to Pier 66. And then we worked with Watts Marine to produce the switchgear that we need to be able to make that connection.
Watts Marine provides the shore power equipment, all the related equipment shoreside to connect to the ship, including cable management. Our scope was to get the equipment on site, get it installed and commissioned ready for that first connection. We don't just install these systems and walk away. We're involved in the connections thereafter, the ongoing maintenance, anything operation-wise, we're still part of that process.
Cruise ships often have their plug-ins located on different parts of the vessel, so we needed to work closely with the cruise line to make sure if we installed it, it would work for their vessels, and in fact, they were installing equipment on their vessels that could meet it.
So this is the cable section of it. It's a significant heft to it. It weighs about 22 pounds a foot. It carries 26,000 volts, a significant amount of power through three main conductors and an armor wire that protects the cable when it's down on the seafloor.
In order to get this underwater cable, we had to order it a year in advance.
Supply chain and materials delivery was a real concern for us. We had pre-ordered some of these materials and still we saw some delays in their delivery. The transformer, which is a critical piece of our switchgear that we have, actually missed its vessel leaving the port. Then the second vessel that it was put on was damaged and had to be shipped to a different vessel. It actually was on three different ships in order to get here. All of the project team would go on every morning and have a look at marine traffic to see where in the world the ship was. That got our attention for sure. In January of 2024, we had the highest stakes portion of this project, and that was the cable installation itself. We'd been planning for months with our contracting partner, Orion, and J.F. Brennan, their cable specialist, on how to install this. They feed the cable down and under Pier 66, and then divers in the water feed that through a guide up through the pier, and then secure that cable at Pier 66. And then we're ready to leave the pier and start laying the main portion of the cable out into the bay over the mile distance that we have to get over to Terminal 46. On installation day, we had clear skies, no wind, but it was very, very cold. We were hovering right around 16 or 17 degrees when we started the day. A lot of nerves on the site. Once completed, we really felt we had turned a corner. It was the largest piece with the highest risk, and it really went off without any flaws at all.
I just loved working with a great partner in the Port of Seattle, and I loved our can-do, find-a-way attitude.
Pier 66 and the other electrification efforts that we've done here at the Port of Seattle have resonated throughout the world. We have created a standard for shore power connections for cruise ships.
This project took a commitment and a lot of work from many, many people here, and everyone should be proud of the work that they achieved.
I have to stop every once in a while to remember how we're contributing to our environment. It's pretty cool.
We estimate that when all cruise ships plug in at Pier 66, we could eliminate over 3,000 metric tons of CO2 in the season. If you combine that with the shore power at Terminal 91, we're estimating 12,000 metric tons of CO2 reduced.
We've set goals to entirely eliminate our carbon emissions. If we work together and we take things one step at a time and are willing to make the significant investments and do things differently than we have before, we can achieve those goals, and we will achieve those goals.